that's pretty cool.
And
we are now going on to Beast versus Pure.
자, 그 유진 선수가 혼자 이거 또 근혜웅씨 또 여기 쳐주네요 채팅창에 네. 자기도 알고 있다
자기도 알고 있다 그혜웅씨에 대해서
야
예, 예, 참 두 선수가 긴장된다
고고고
네 맞습니다 유진 선수 에, 뭐 경기 시작 전에 됐다고 하네요 자 미스트에서의 경기인데요 유진 선수 박세정 선수의 경기입니다 어떤 경기가 나올 수 있을지 자 가보도록 하겠습니다
Alright, going into game number one of the second series here, Pure versus Beast. Winner of this best of three, of course, will go on to play against Tyson. And loser faces Mind in the loser's match. That's not going to be nice. Alright, so it looks like Pure will be spawning on the left side as the yellow Protoss. So let me take care of this.
네 이번 경기의 어떤 그 포인트는 앞서 이제 인터뷰에서도 나왔습니다만 두 선수
Right, we are good to go.
실제 그 프로에서 활약하던 그 시절에서는
So
박세준 선수가 압도적인 인지도를 가지고 있었고
So Pure, who is this handsome gentleman by the way, who's even sporting his We Made Fox tag, is not very good. He's not very good. In his prime, he was very good. He was a very strong Protoss. Actually, wait a minute. Is he one of the six Protoss dragons? Hold on. Wait. Who are the dragons? Stork? Jangbi? Cal? Free? Bisu? Shit, I'm just making stuff up now. I have no idea. Damn, that's embarrassing. It was Free one of them? Or was it Pure? Was it both? Or was it neither? Maybe it's neither. I feel like neither of them really deserve to be a dragon. They're not particularly good. Pure's not a dragon? Free was a dragon? Shit! I guess Free was better than Pure. Who did I miss? I only said 5, right? Stork, Jangbi, Cal, Free, Bisu. Yeah, who's the 6th one? Okay, so I said all those. Oh, Best! Of course, Best! Best, that's the one. So you know my problem? My problem is I can never tell Free and Pure apart. I keep thinking they're like the same person. For some reason, I don't know why. They look kind of similar though, don't they? Oh, Best, of course. Best. Whatever. Could have been worse. I could have said, like, Backho. Ha! Backho a dragon. Oh man, this little probe. This little piece of shit probe. Get out of here! Man, this is making me mad. Oh man, he turned it into a ghost drone too. Awesome. Anyway, oh, apparently we got a Free fan in the chat too. He's all getting his knickers in a twist. Said Free wasn't good. Alright, Free was alright. He was legit. He was okay. Yeah, why wasn't Harangue a dragon, man? Harangue should have been a dragon. Man, that's not fair. Harangue could have killed all those dragons. PvP, for sure. Anyway, we got the good old third hatch of the third base here for Mr. Beast. Okay, so let's talk a little bit about Beast then, since I'm done BMing Pure. So Beast is one of the reasons why I don't Liquibet. There was one season, well, basically like the first season where Brutal or Liquibet started again, where I was like, hey, you know what, I'm gonna try Liquibetting now. And then like there was an SRT, I think, I'm pretty sure it was an SRT where Beast was playing. And I didn't really know who he was. And so basically like every single match I bet against Beast. All the way, and he won every single time up to the finals. And in the finals, I was like, alright, screw it. I'm betting on Beast. And then I think he lost the finals. I was like, God damn it! I think that's how it went. I could be wrong. He could have just won the finals anyway, in which case the story is backwards, and I didn't vote on him. But whatever, basically, the point is, I lost all the liquid bets because every time I voted against Beast, he won. And then whenever I voted, and then like the one time I voted on him, he lost. So this guy, man, this guy, I don't know what's up with him. Apparently he's good in team leagues and not in individual leagues or something. Oh man, Harem. Harem DMing Stork. Doesn't even affect me anymore. I haven't even seen Stork like play. I haven't even just seen Stork in forever. I don't even know what he's doing now. Like the last I heard, he broke like a 300-day losing streak in Pro League or something. I don't even know. What has become of the Dear Dino Toss? Anyway. Looks like are we getting in? Yes, we're getting in to see. Oh no, we're not getting in. What? What is up with that? There was no way that was on purpose, was it? That has gotta just be. That is just gonna be luck. I think the Zealot killed the drone though. I saw a dead drone on the ground. So that's pretty good, at least. He's back to code B. Playing code A. What's the highest code? S? What the hell? Wait, Flash is code B? Wait, what? What do you mean Flash is code B? I thought Flash was owning it up. What happened? Man, what is going on? Bogus and Fantasy are code B. I thought Bogus was great. I thought he like changed his name and stuff. He was like, hey, I'm gonna be innovation now and be good. And he sort of did too. Man, what is going on? Oh man. I am out of the loop. I am seriously out of the loop. Also, apparently the stream is like several minutes behind me. Because I asked like the code S question a while ago and people are just answering. So now I'm going to be really confused when I read the chat. I don't know what people are talking about anymore. Anyway, it looks like we're going to have the initial couple of Corsairs snagging a couple of Overlords. No bigs. Snap that Corsair neck! Oh no, it's a little bit too slow. Only two Terrans in Code S. Well, surely this is just karma, right? Considering, you know, the first few seasons of GSL were only Terrans, right? Right? It's balanced, man. Oh god. Oh, good reaction. Good job, Beast. He only lost one. He might lose two. No. Nice. Oh, good job. Oh, he's even gonna block the DT. Oh, good. 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 I'm rooting for Beast, if you haven't noticed. Good job. So, we're going Mass Corsairs, but apparently there's no way to block your Probin. Oh wait, no, apparently there is behind the main, but you've got to do it. Just have like the two pawns next to each other. Does that actually block the Probin? I guess it must. Or else Pure's just going to look very silly. In the meantime, Beast has got a good number of Scourge out to help deal with these pesky Corsairs. He's gonna have to spread them out a little bit. That's a lot of, that's, what is that, 6 plus 1 Corsairs now? 5 or 6 plus 1 Corsairs? Those will be able to tear through Scourge. Easy peasy. Yeah, that is 6 Corsairs. It's gonna be quite bad for any Scourge to come over. You can see he's not actually stacking them though. So clearly this double pylon pro thing has just not worked out. Which I didn't think it would. So, stacking is out the window. That is mini Scourge. I'm surprised he's not building any Muta though. Because normally the way you do this is you actually build a few Muta to tank the shots, because Mutas actually tank a lot better than the Scourge do, obviously. But at least he looks like he's actually done a decent job here of killing enough. Oh shit! Oh shit! Oh shit, there's a drop! Oh shit, I think Stratos actually warned me about this and I just completely forgot. Oh no! Oh, it's a drop game. Oh, it is definitely a disconnect. Oh my god, alright. There's a, ladies and gentlemen, this is a disconnect. They're gonna re-game. Ah! Alright, let's skip ahead. Skip to the re. Alright, go re! Go re. Go re. It's all good. Nothing happened. Look, we're even in the same spawns. Oh man, yeah, Stratos, I totally forgot, dude. I just completely forgot. Whatever, it's fine. Oh man. That's my bad. That's my bad. Man, I didn't have anything interesting even. Ah, it would've been cool if there was like some action, but just like all the build up. Oh man, it's like all the foreplay and none of the action. Mega blue balls going on here. At least we get to go re just immediately, so that's good. Anyway, so we're going again. So let's see if they just do the same builds here. It's always actually really funny to see these regames and whether the players do the exact same build or not, because presumably they've just, you know, practiced a build on this map for this matchup if they've prepared. So do you do the same build and hope that your opponent doesn't just try and just doesn't counter it? Or do you just, you know, do something, wings, just wing it, but have a less practiced build? Is this an overpool? Okay, this is an overpool. Yeah, I mean, in particular, I remember the PvP that was a draw game between, I think it was Harangi and, was it Jaehoon or Tyson or something? And basically, they just like DT rushed each other on Jade and it ended up being a draw because they couldn't kill each other. And then they did a regame and just did completely different builds, and it was just like 4-gate goon against a Robo opening, and obviously killed a Robo. So that was pretty funny. Anyway. Let's see how long the probe delays the natural this time, at least. Let's see if he gets it as long as he did the first game. Not even close. Not even close. I think he was a little bit suspicious about the ramp block. So he just went to check. And even if he got the block off, if you go overpool, getting your hatchery blocked for a little while doesn't actually matter because you can just make lings instead. So he's going to forge Nexus Cannon. Pretty good. Pretty standard. Pretty legit. And apparently that probe is just going to be completely ignored. Oh, he's going to go hunt down this drone, stop him from making a third. That's going to be a pain in the butt. Or not. No, he is. Nope. No, wait. Why is he not shooting that drone? Oh no, he just went the other way. Okay. Whoa! Hello. Oh, what? Buffer into two links in the natural? Oh, man! Pure! Pure! Oh my god, don't lose a second probe, dude. Hey! At least he blocked the third. So that gas mining is going to be inefficient, but he's going to build like another hatchery there anyway, so in the long run, I don't think that makes a difference. Actually, you know what? I think that pylon of the third made absolutely no difference whatsoever. Because the Zerg's not going to take that third gas without having another hatchery there anyway. And I don't think the mineral mining is impacted enough for that to have done anything. I really don't think that actually just did anything. Anyway, it's fun though. It's good times. It, you know, it makes you feel like you're the boss when you're Protoss, you know what I mean? Just gotta show that Zerg who's in charge. Show him who's wearing the pants in the matchup. Karim knows what I'm talking about. Okay, so I guess we're just gonna... Oh, we're doing something different! We're not going for the Spire this time! Oh, we're going 3-H Hydra! Oh, it's dirty! Dirty, dirty, dirty! Beast! Dirty little beast? Oh man, alright. So this isn't gonna be an all-in, so don't worry, it's not gonna be some kind of crazy hydro bust. It could be, but in all likelihood, he's just gonna put on a little bit of pressure, you know, kill the gateway in the forge. And then that'll be that. Ooh, but we're going straight Citadel. Oh man, wait, both players do not want to just, you know, do the whole thing over again like last game, and are going for the much more aggressive opening. So we're gonna have some speed lot action against the Edge Hydra. Although he hasn't built an extra gateway yet, which is slightly confusing to me. Is he just like gonna DT rush? That'd be quite peculiar. That would be quite peculiar. Okay, wait, he went Citadel first and then Stargate? Yeah, because he's not getting plus one, so he's not actually going speed level. What the hell is he doing? He's doing like Stair DT. But is this actually how you do Stair DT? Is this like real Stair DT? Is it the Bisou build? I don't even know what the Bisou build is, man. Everything's the Bisou build. Well, whatever this is, it's gonna be Corsairs and it's gonna be DTs. And that's gonna be cool. That's gonna be cool. Now, it's gonna be curious because these Hydras are actually here fast enough to protect this first Overlord. So I don't know how he's gonna not die right now. Like, how is this not death? What the fuck? Oh man, I'm sitting here scratching my chin like, what is this build? And then, well, nope. It's no build. Man, Pierre, you suck. Oh, all right, hold on. Gotta get the next part. Hey. Yes, Kratos, I totally was like, what? After you said that, I was looking at like the Hydras coming in. I was thinking, I was like, wait, Kratos said this was an amazing game. Like, how the hell does Pure survive this? I was racking my brain. I was like, is this gonna be the greatest hold in the history of PvZ? And it wasn't. Oh my god. So after all of that, after just like, you know, all of the build up in the first game into disconnect, into just Hydra Bust death. I mean, really? And why the hell is Beast watching the replay? He won the game! Man, get in the next game! Stop messing around, you won the game, man! Get out! Get out the replay! What are you doing? What is this guy doing? I guess he's trying to figure out why Pure had nothing. Yeah. Because Pure had actually relatively little. And by relatively, I mean he just had nothing there. Harm saying that apparently Pure beat Zero and Killer all the time on stream. Well, I guess beating Zero is something, but you know, nowadays everyone's beating Killer. Am I right? Oh! No, seriously. Like, Love TV League? Out! SSL? Out! What's up with Killer? So I've got some hand warmer action going on for Pure. Come on, get in the game! Get in the game! What are they doing? What are you guys doing? Let's go! Chop chop!